Southwold has, as you know, a sort of particular quality. I don't know many towns around the country like this that are seaside towns, that are sort of all-year towns as well, and always look good. You know, some seaside towns look a bit sad and shabby when they're out of season, but Southwold has its own sort of internal energy, and it's a good, nice, sort of, it's a lovely little town, and it just needs a cinema. You know, it's got everything else. About time it had a cinema, so now it has.
And a cinema this small, 60 people, it's not going to be a cinema where you're going to get privacy like you used to in the cinema that shut down in the 60s.
Well, I mean, there are a lot of cinemas now, especially in the multiplexes, where a screen will be only 60 or 70 seats, so you'll still be packed in. Here, you can be packed in some style, and you can have an organ rising from the floor. Excuse the expression.
Can I say, first of all, thank you very much to Maureen Churchill for the street organ that she's been playing, I think, for the last hour. Thank you very much. We're trying to make this a sort of authentic period event. We also have here, you may be surprised to see a fireman here. The building is totally compliant with fire regulations and has been approved, you'll be pleased to hear. But you'll all be acquainted with the 1910 Cinematographic Act, which required... You know it, Audrey knows it, yeah. It requires that every film presentation at a cinema had to be attended by a fireman in the full outfit. And Peter Bullivant, one of our local firemen, has kindly agreed to come along wearing the authentic brass helmet. Thank you, Peter. This is the culmination of 2 years of work on this building. The Southwold Film Society only began in 1998, and we've shown 13 seasons of films, with 10 films each. I think there's 130 films. We started showing them at Eversley School following a race night when somebody donated a 60mm projector to us so we could show films of these horse races, and we all fell in love with that machine, and in fact we're still using it today. We thought it would be a good fundraiser to show films at Eversley, and we set up a film society to do that. Eversley unfortunately closed a couple of years later, but the film society carried on, and we went to the Stella Peskett Hall, and I think it's a tribute to cinema, the magic of cinema, that any space, when you turn the lights out, can become the magic world of cinema, even the Stella Peskett Hall with the snails. I know you love them, but the snails and the spiders.
Oh, hello there, hello everybody. Well, nice to get a parking space in Southwold, I must say. Well, as someone who, thank you, John, for that wonderful build-up, not so good for Woody Allen, quite good for me. As one who has long associations and a great deal of fondness for Southwold, and long associations and a great deal of fondness for cinema generally, I'm doubly pleased and honoured to be asked to come here today to open the new Electric Picture Palace. Southwold, as you know now, has everything except a cinema. Now it has a cinema. And I remember the days when Southwold Cinema closed down, 1963. And I don't know if many people here who remember the original Southwold Cinema. Hands up, anyone who remembers the Southwold Cinema? Yes, yes, quite a few here. Well, I used to come here for my summer holidays, and my then girlfriend, now my wife, and I used to occasionally go off to the Southwold Cinema to, you know, increase our appreciation of cinema generally. And it's very, I'm very glad that there was someone like that, and very sad that it closed for so long. And I'm very glad to say that in this cinema here, I'm told there is, as part of the new furnishings, a cuddle seat. I'm afraid it's booked for the next year and a half, but if you'd like to put your name down, now's the time. So anyway, the cinema is a wonderful tribute to John Bennett. It's a wonderful tribute also to the people of Southwold who've supported him. It's a living embodiment that small is beautiful and size doesn't matter. And I just want to say one other thing, which is that John and I know and the Southwold Film Society want to use this as a focal point to interest local people, and especially young people locally, in cinema and in the making of films. So I very much hope that the words that were said earlier about a Southwold Film Festival may come true. And I very much hope that this cinema here will act as a focus for renewed interest in cinema in a town which has been used so often on film. And I have very, very happy memories of filming here for East of Ipswich. So anyway, no further ado, I will very happily do what I have to do, which I think is cut the ribbon and declare that after 40 years, absent Southwold now has a cinema again. So should I come down and do the honours? Okay, here we are. This is the great moment. Oh, the scissors, the green scissors, lovely. Well, I now declare the Electric Picture Palace Southwold well and truly open. Two, please. Senior citizens. Special reduction. Hello. Two for the back row, please. Oh, I mean, just back row, whatever. The cuddle seat.
Row.
Oh, that's
very
it. Thank
nice,
you, lovely.
Michael.
Thank you very much. There we are. I'm lucky. One of the lucky 66.
He's
spelled Woody Allen wrong. Okay, what's the film now, please?
This is a certificate of the Friends of the Film Society for the Electric Picture Palace, and you're an honorary member.
Thank you. Thank you.
Membership
card. I'm getting matinees only or evenings as well.
Life membership card.